Yeah. Welcome to another day, another video, another cup of coffee. Holy moly, that's hot. And a brand new blue hoodie. Yeah, I'm just hanging out at my parents' house right now. Sunday morning, lazy day, nothing doing. I am going to make my parents some brunch in a little while. It's kind of a tradition we have, or they have, and whenever I'm around, I join in on that, and I usually do the cooking because it alleviates somebody else having to do that. And for me, it's like bacon and eggs. Okay, I could do that in my sleep with my eyes blindfolded and my arms tied behind my back. So in the meantime, I'm just messing around on my computadora and having myself just a nice relaxing morning. After brunch, I do believe I'm going to watch Nomadland, which if you're watching a van life video right now and you don't know what Nomadland is, well, you probably should look that up. Long story short, Nomadland is a new movie starring Francis McDormand, I believe is how you pronounce her name, and it's about a woman who, through whatever life choices she goes through, I don't know the full story yet, I haven't seen it. Anyways, whatever, her life pushes her into a point where she becomes a nomad, a van dweller. What's a nomad? Well, the nomads are specifically the group of van dwellers that live down in the desert out here in the West. Bob Wells, I believe it's Cheap RV Living Channel. Well, he's pretty much the guru. If you're a retired person and you're living in a van or in an RV or something non-traditional like that, chances are you've watched a couple of Bob Wells videos. Well, I know I have because he really has great information. And anyways, he's a bit of a guru. So those are the nomads. And the lady that made this movie, I don't know her name off the top of my head. She pretty much made the movie with only two real named actors, as far as I've seen. Francis McDormand and who's the other one? Oh, man. I'm drawing a complete blank right now. He was in the movie Good Night, Good Luck. All I can keep thinking is Jason Statham, Jonathan Strathern, something like that. I know, I'm scratching my ear, it's gross. Nomadland. David Strathern. Okay, now Bob Wells is actually in the movie. So what was I saying before I got sidetracked with David Strathern? The lady that made this movie, since I have the information pulled up now, Chloé Zhao, I believe is the name. She made it with, I mean, pretty much only two real named actors in it. And the rest of the people in the movie, from what I've heard, are real nomads. So it's kind of like this weird amalgamation of documentary, reality, and fiction all kind of fused into one. Because she takes a fictional character, but throws that fictional character into a real environment with real people. I can't wait to see this. I've watched a bunch of little videos, reviews of it, an in-depth on the cinematography, which looks awesome. I mean, a lot of low light, kind of gun and go, just the camera and practical elements. I'm really into that. What I've seen, it looks beautiful. So I'm going to stop talking because I've gone on for like 5 minutes already. But later on, I will be doing a full in-depth review on Nomadland, which according to this website is an astonishing movie and a worthy Oscar frontrunner. Interesting thing is this is really going to open a lot of people's eyes to van life. You know, people of a certain sect or, I don't know, age group or interest know about van life. You're watching a van life video. I'm making a van life video and living my life in a van. But a lot of people, like my parents, had no idea this was a thing, and nor did they realize the extent of it. Because when I first got into it, my dad was like, oh, well, maybe you should like write a book or do a blog about how to get into van life. And I said, there's like 100 people already did that. He said, really? It's that popular? And then over the course of, you know, the last 8-9 months or however long I've been doing this since July, all of a sudden he's realized, oh, yeah, this is a big thing. This is like a new counterculture movement, which it is in a way, yes. Not a counterculture. This is a new culture. Van life is a new culture. The only thing it's counter to is all those things you've been taught as a child and a young adult about what success and stability and being an adult means. Well, this kind of throws all that in its face. So then I guess it is counterculture. Yeah, I know. 5 minutes turned into like 7. Okay. I'm going to drink my coffee and S the F up. It's empty. It all feels the same way to me. And sometimes I'm drunk. Heading back to my parents' house to watch Nomadland. My dad said he wanted to watch the movie too, so instead of just sitting here in my van watching it, which would be kind of a cool experience, I'm going to do it from the comfort of a couch in their living room with their big old TV and surround sound. So that'll be a good experience too, considering that movie theaters aren't open anymore. So I just finished watching Nomadland, and I have to say, first initial impression, I loved it. Now, it's not going to be a movie for everybody. I have to say that right off the bat. And it's not by any means an uplifting view of van life. Now, it does have uplifting moments, but it's really kind of a slow burn of a movie, and my dad and I were just talking about it over dinner, and he said he wishes it would have been a little bit more lighthearted in seeing van life. And I said, well, you know what? The van life was, to me, an incidental part of the movie. What the movie really was is a story of a woman trying to deal with the grief of loss and how to handle that and move forward with your life. And in so doing, she finds herself falling into van life, you know, getting into things like Bob Wells videos and cheap RV living. And she finds herself out in the desert with the nomads out on quartzite. And I'm not going to give it all away. The cinematography is beautiful. A lot of it's handheld. And, you know, my dad and I both agreed that it really didn't feel like you were watching a movie most of the time. I'd say 95% of the movie just feels like you're right there along watching somebody go through their life and deal with their struggles as they come about, kind of what life really is like, right? So it's not a flashy movie by any means. It's also not necessarily a movie that's gonna like inspire a lot of people to van life, but it does tackle some interesting van life issues that I think everybody's faced, whether that's kind of,
you know, the first time when she tells somebody that she's living in her van, and it's kind of hard for her to spit out, you know, I've been there in certain situations where you feel like, oh, people are going to think of me different, especially when she was at the mechanics. Yeah, I've been in that situation. Like, when I broke down in Morro Bay, well, can't you just leave it with us and we get to it when we get to it? And I wanted to tell the guy, no, I live in it. I can't just leave it here indefinitely. So I did definitely relate to a lot of the movie. Now the heartache, grief, sorrow, kind of, I would say an underlying theme, but it's heavy. It's overlying. I can't really relate too much to that. I can on minimal levels. I've had loss. I think we all have. But I never really held on to it quite the way that she does. But overall, I give it 1, 2, 3 thumbs up. And if you're in van life or interested in van life or just even curious about it, I definitely recommend it. It's on Hulu, so watch it as many times as you want. A free month trial, sign up for Hulu. I wish I was getting sponsored to say that. But I signed up for a free trial. My dad signed up for a free trial. So if anything, this movie is helping Hulu out. The other thing that I thought was kind of funny is the Nomads and Bob Wells are in a lot of this movie. And I couldn't just help but thinking that, boy, Bob Wells' channel is going to explode after this. And good for him, because he's doing a great service for a lot of people out there. I've watched my share of Bob's videos, and if you've gotten into this van life thing or just kind of always surfing through van life videos, you probably run across his cheap RV living. Now, I think I'm pretty much spoken out about my feelings for the movie. If I have any other thoughts throughout the rest of the night, I am going to pop in and let you know. But I thought, you know, this suitable background for doing a review for Nomadland, the movie, because half of the movie is shot at sunset or sunrise, which I don't blame them because it is beautiful. Some of the locations have really inspired me because I've been kind of hanging out and around town a lot lately, and I want to get back out exploring. So I don't know where, don't know when this next week I'm going to make a bit of time out of my arduous schedule, and we're going to go check out something interesting. So I highly recommend it. Check it out. Hulu, Nomadland, starring Francis McDormand. And, yeah, that's my movie review.